Shubhodaya. Good morning.
Shubhodaya. Good morning.
It's, yoga is not only physical stretch, mental stretch also is required. Last time we chanted a mantra from Bhagavad Gita. We'll try to remember that one, and we'll try to make an effort to remember that. It's a very motivational shloka. It's, we'll chant once and we'll repeat together. It's a Gita. It's a many Gitas are there. It's a Gita. Gita is a masculine, whereas Bhagavad Gita, tha means it's a feminine. Feminine means, shloka means it is to be sung. It's a Gita. Gita, Bhagavad Gita means it is conducive for singing. It's the meaning of Bhagavad Gita, whereas Uddhava Geet and Bhikshu Geet, Rudra Geet, it's all masculine, whereas Bhagavad Gita, Gita means it's a feminine. Tasma tvamuttishta yasholabhastva jitva shatrun bhungshvarajyam samruddham mamaivete nihata purvameva nimitta matram bhavasavyasachin. We'll repeat together. Tasma tvamuttishta yasholabhastva jitva shatrun bhungshvarajyam samruddham mamaivete nihata purvameva nimitta matram bhavasavyasachin. So again, to recap the meaning, that savyasachi means one who can fight with the left arm also. That broader meaning of that one, one who is ambitious, one who wants to do things, not a lazy person. That a person who wants to accomplish things, who wants to elevate himself, that person is called a Savyasachi. Uttishta, Uttishta means, oh, get up. The person who wants to do something, oh, get up. Tasmatum Uttishta, Yasholabhastva. There are many opportunities. Opportunities are plenty. Don't be in slumber. Get up. Opportunities are many. Tvamuttishta, Yasholabhastva, get the glory. Yasholabhastva jitva shatrun bhungshvarajyam samudram. There is a plenty of opportunities. Enjoy that, accomplish and enjoy the those things, those benefits. And mamai vete nihata purvameva, I already conquered the enemies for you. I already paved the way for you. All you have to do, you are mere instrument. And with this one, you accomplish. I already paved the way for you. You get up and enjoy. Enjoy the opportunities. That's the meaning of that one. That it's if person is too proud of his accomplishment, it's a reminder saying that you are just an instrument. You have no freedom. That because of my grace, you accomplish that one. And those people who are bit doubtful whether I can do or not, if they are not very sure, for those people also it's motivation. Get up and accomplish. It's a motivation. Whenever your mind is disturbed or down, you think of this shloka. It's in the 11th chapter Bhagavad Gita. It's shloka 33, and we'll try to repeat for few classes so that it's a exercise for the mind. Not only yoga, it's a physical stretch, stretching our memory also. And last week we covered Gheranda Samhita. Gheranda Samhita, it's one of the texts of yoga, yoga sutras, yoga philosophy. It has 7 chapters. One is, so first chapter we covered last week is purification. Purification through Shatkarma Kriyas. Second chapter covers with strengthening. Strengthening the body through asanas. And third chapter talks about studying. After strengthening, you got to steady the body. Steady the body through mudras. Fourth one, you got to calm the body. Calm the body through its pratyahara. Doing the pratyahara, you calm the body. Fifth chapter talks about you got to lighten the body. Lighten the body through pranayama. And the sixth chapter, it talks about reflecting. You got to reflect on subtle things in the life. Reflect, contemplate on that one through meditation. And seventh chapter talks about isolation and it's identifying ourselves with the higher thing. It's a samadhi. It talks about in the seven steps. And the first chapter, that purification, Shat Karma Kriyas, six ways of purification, purifying ourselves. And it's a Neti, Dauti, Kapalabhati, Nauli, Basti and Tratak. These are the six Kriyas of cleansing ourselves. It's a Neti. Neti is, one is few types of Netis are there. One is Jalneti. Jalneti is, today we will do Jalneti Kriya. It's a Jala. Jala means water. You are pouring the lukewarm water through one nostril. Lukewarm saline water through one nostril. It comes out through the other nostrils. It cleanses the sinus. And another Kriya, it's called Sutra Neti. Sutra Neti is a benefit of that one. It takes us, makes the Kechari Mudra happen. It's a step ahead. Though it's a Sutra Netri cannot be taught in the bigger class. That's why I started a smaller class, that teacher's training. Those in the smaller class we can teach Sutra Netri and all. It's not conducive for teaching in a bigger class. It's a Sutra Netri. Sutra Netri, it's a Kechari Mudra. It's a people with blocked nostrils, people with breathing disorder, people with snoring problem, they find Sutra Neti beneficial. And the second one is Kapalabhati. Kapalabhati is force active exhale and passive inhale that we will practice today. It's doing Kapalabhati, cleanses the sinus. Glow in the face increases, our intelligence improves, slumber in the mind, laziness is dispelled and becomes, activates the mind and lung capacity increases. That is the Kapalabhati. Third is Dauti Kriya. Dauti Kriya is cleansing the our esophagus tube, that our food pipe up to the stomach. It cleanses the stomach up. It's people with bile related problem, phlegm related problem, they find beneficial. Excess bile, excess phlegm gets released from the body. What you do early morning on the empty stomach, drink a couple of glasses of lukewarm water and immediately tickle your inner tongue or root of your tongue and massage that one using these three fingers, and whatever you drank, it comes out. It's a Dauti Kriya. And another Dauti Kriya is, you would have experienced that one, and some of them are divers are there, they would have experienced that one. When you dive into the water, and sometimes water goes into the nostrils, and when the water goes into the nostrils, you start spitting out through your mouth. That is another Dauti Kriya. Suck the water through nostrils and spit it out. That is another Dauti Kriya. Another Dauti Kriya is sometimes at home also, when we drink water too quickly, it comes out through the nostrils. That you get the sneeze, you comes out through the nostrils. It is another Dauti Kriya. Drink and force the water to come out through the nostrils. It cleanses the your mouth and this part, entire thing gets cleansed. Another Dauti Kriya is Danta Dauti. It's every morning, that apart from brushing the teeth with your brush, is use thumb and forefinger, massage the upper gums all through and lower gums, and lift your tongue, massage the lower palate and massage the upper palate, and massage all over the tongue. And you tickle your tongue also. And after that, pull your tongue out. And with both thumb and index finger in both hands, try to pull the tongue as out as you can. Pulling the tongue out, it cures the old age. It's Hatha Yoga says it slows down the old age. old age complications are released, removed, and diseases from the body goes out, and glow in the face increases. That we can do every day. That part of your cleaning that you do that danta dauti also. And another dimension of dauti kriya, dauti and basti, another dimension we'll talk next time. And basti kriya is basti is cleansing intestine down is one is called as jalabasti is stand in clear water, is in a river, clear water, stand there up to the navel, water should be clean and pure, and pull your rectal muscles up and down, water gets sucked in and it cleanses the large intestine. People with the bile related problem, gas related problem, that they find beneficial. People with constipation problem, they find that one beneficial. Another dimension of basti kriya, yesterday we did that one, it's shankha prakshalana kriya we did, and quite a few people that had a very good success, they are still smiling here, that they drank around 4-5 liters of water and flushing the intestine, that thorough prakshalana means washing, shankha means it's a conch, our stomach looks like a conch, thorough washing. It's rejuvenates us. You feel the lightness in the body and build up that it cleanses the whole our elementary canal. Our elementary canal, it's about 30 feet long. Our intestine itself, it's about 23 feet long. It's a lot of stuff gets accumulated. It doesn't get cleaned properly. It's a shankha prakshalana kriya. It's a entire 30 feet of our elementary canal gets cleaned, that we feel very light, and it's one of the secrets of keeping a good health, that I recommend everyone to do that one once a year at least. It's you feel the benefit, those who have done that, they will feel the benefit of that one, shankha prakshalana kriya. And another one is Navali kriya is strengthening the abdominal muscles, moving the stomach muscles. It removes the laziness, it energizes the body, energy level in the body goes up. That is the Navali kriya. And Tratakriya increases the eyesight, withdraws the mind, makes the mind for people who can't go to sleep, people with insomnia problem, people with cataract problem, they find that one beneficial. It's a gazing at the lamp, and we do that one in the next term. It's a Tratakriya for the eyes. And these are the six kriyas we covered, all six. It's we practice one today. It's Jalaneti. The six kriyas is Neti, Kapalabhati, Dauti, Basti, Tratak, and Navali. Navali kriya, these are the six kriyas. It's a first chapter of Gheranda Samhita covers this one in exhaust, and Hatha Yoga Pradipika also talks about these cleaning techniques. Lay down on your back.